So we're in downtown Denver for the Catalyst Health Project. We're in the parking garage, and we are using the Vulkem EWS vehicular system over some areas that are going to be on occupied space. So that's going to be on the second level. It's going to be roughly 3,000 square feet. The two conditions we have is going to be just a flat deck. So we're going to have parking areas that we're not going to be on the exact drive lane, but where people park. So relatively flat, cut and dry. It's going to just be our self-leveling coat of the base coat. Our second condition is going to be a ramp where we actually have to use the roller version and forego using the filler powder and the wear coat. We'll just go with two coats. That way we get that buildup and the durability. The reason they went with EWS was because they were looking at traditional urethane coatings and were not too thrilled about only getting a 5-year warranty. So we came in with the EWS system and were able to offer them a 10-year warranty. This was over occupied space, so it was pretty important to them. The turnaround time was a big deal as well. We were able to get it done in 2 days. You know, with a standard urethane coating, it was going to take a little over a week with shot blasting and prepping and then also laying down the coating. So we were able to save them a lot of time as well.
Yeah, absolutely. That's the greatest thing, that they were able to come out and actually walk us through step by step on what we need to do, especially with a newer system and it kicking off so fast. You know, we have to have someone there to tell us exactly what to do so that the next time we do it on our own, we're ready to go and we know what we're doing.
A couple of things that Tremco brings to the table that I don't know that anybody else does that is very important. We come to the site after surface prep has been performed. We do a moisture meter reading with our Tremco CM-E4. And we do that because we want to know how much moisture is in the concrete. The second thing we do is we like to have a temperature gun, especially when we're about ready to prepare the material for placement. We want to know where we're at because the initiator for the EWS has ranges of where you should be and how much initiator goes in each gallon. That's based on the temperature of the concrete.
They were out from the get-go. We came and presented them with this option. Scotty Stinson was out here with us on the initial meeting with Beck to present this product to them. And so that really helped sell it and giving them the warranty. There's so many more benefits to it that make it a better system. And so having a rep there to be able to walk a owner through or a GC through really helped us out as well.
And then from there, I've made periodic site visits just to kind of check on the condition of the concrete, make sure everything's fine before we lay down the coating. As you mentioned, we're going to have a tech rep come out on site, Mike Bader. He'll be joining us tomorrow to ensure the install goes smoothly. So he'll be here from primer all the way to the top coat just to make sure everything's laid down correctly.
One of the things we did with the crew was that we had them grid the system so that every bucket had a place from point A to point B. That guarantees our mill thickness, but it also guarantees that the guys are putting it down at the right square foot per gallon. One of the things that we found with EWS is it's important to have the mixing station as close as possible to the work area. Because our pot lives are short, sometimes 10, 12 minutes for a 6-gallon unit, we need to be as close as possible. And then we stage the material. We separate it into primers, base coats, wear coats, and top coats. That way, two things happen. The guys at the mix station don't get confused about what we're doing. Also, it shows them a pattern of where we're going next. One thing I noticed on this job particularly is the crew size. I like to have two guys at the mixing station and at least four guys out doing the work. So that's a total of six. We had six today. And we did 1,800 square feet in about 6 hours. The product cured out in 45 minutes or less in between coats, which allowed us to speed up the process. We were able to add more initiator when we wanted to. The crew was able to keep up. That is a unique feature that now we're in charge of the curing process, not Mother Nature. The job went pretty smooth. We noticed that the shot blast was a little aggressive. We'd like to see a CSP 3 or 4. We think we had a 5 to 6. So our primer soaked in very quickly. So instead of getting 90 square feet per gallon, we only got about 45. But that's typical because the primer then soaked into the concrete. Other than that, this job has gone extremely smooth.
Yeah, I mean, you have to have everything prepared. You know, we had to have everything in its place to be able to get everything mixed because of how quick this cures and kicks off. You know, you gotta have guys that are ready to go when you're ready to go. And so our crew is ready. This is the same crew that did our helipad, so they had some familiarity with it. Just even that, they knew how quickly we had to get this going. So yeah, I mean, it's a fast install, but that's great for us.